This machine made out of 304 matchboxes can play a game of tic-tac-toe with you, also known as Noughts and Crosses. Not only that, but it can consistently win against you. Even against the best of strategies, it is capable of not losing a single game. Surprisingly enough, this machine was first designed decades ago and is only made up of beads and, well, some matchboxes. How? Let's find out. All of this started in 1960, when British computer science researcher Donald Michie accepted a bet from his colleague who suggested that building such a machine that could learn to play tic-tac-toe was not possible. The point was not just to construct a machine that could play tic-tac-toe, but rather a machine that with no prior knowledge of how to play the game, aside from the rules, could gradually learn and become an expert at the game. Back then, computers were not readily available, but for Michie, some matchboxes and beads were enough to build up this machine. He named it Menace. Every matchbox was uniquely numbered for indexing, and had a drawing of tic-tac-toe grid on the front, representing a unique game position. The only exceptions were the duplicates. Inside every matchbox were some colored beads. 9 different color beads were available, and each color represented a move on the square of the grid. A V-shaped card was also glued inside the tray of every matchbox, and that was it. Menace was ready to play a game of tic-tac-toe. Let's play a game with it then, shall we? First rule, Menace always goes first. Why? Because otherwise we will need much more than 304 matchboxes. And since Menace doesn't have its own hands, we will need to operate and play the game on its behalf as well. Let's start. It's Menace's first turn. We pick up a matchbox with an empty game state, shake it, and slide open the tray to take out the very first bead that comes in front. Blue bead. This means Menace's first move is on the top middle square. Our turn now. We make our move to the very middle square. Menace's turn next. Again, we find the matching game state matchbox, pick it up, shake it, and open the tray. Red bead this time. Menace's second move is on the bottom middle square. The game goes on like this, and in the end, we win. Wait, but wasn't this machine supposed to be good at playing the game? Yes, but it needs to learn while playing the game. And in order to learn, we need to apply an important system. The system of reward and punishment. The system mechanics works like this. If Menace loses the game, we remove one bead of the corresponding color from each matchbox that was used by Menace to play during that game. If Menace draws, we add one bead of the corresponding color to each matchbox that was used by Menace to play during that game. And if Menace wins the game, we add 3 beads of the corresponding color to each matchbox. Furthermore, the matchboxes that were used in playing earlier moves are given less significance when deciding on the number of beads to add or to remove. This system of reward and punishment increases the probability of Menace playing the winning move more often than the losing one, essentially encouraging good behavior and discouraging bad one. In 1961, Michie played a tournament against Menace for the first time. All the game rules were exactly as we had just seen. The tournament lasted for 220 plays of the game, taking 2 consecutive 8-hour sessions. Initially, Menace was bad at the game, but gradually it learned to improve. After about 20 plays, Menace was starting to draw and win sometimes as well. But after about 150 plays, it was capable of coping with anything. It became impossible to win against Menace even while using the best tic-tac-toe strategy. The best outcome you could get was a draw. Using the same matchboxes approach, you can theoretically build a machine to play any game you want, but practically it will be far from feasible. To give you an example, to construct a machine that can simultaneously learn and play a game of chess, you will need approximately 10 to the power of 43 matchboxes. That is 1 followed by 43 zeros. If you try to fit these matchboxes in a sphere, its radius would be 4 multiplied by 10 to the power of 12 meters. In terms of visualizing, this means that if the sun was at the center of this machine, you might need to travel past planet Uranus to search for the right matchbox. This approach was only the beginning towards the construction of intelligent machines. In 1996, IBM's Deep Blue chess computer defeated the reigning world chess champion, Garry Kasparov. One of the significant contributions Donald Mickey made to the field of artificial intelligence and machine learning was the introduction of reward and punishment system, now recognized as reinforcement learning, which is one of the three common methodologies used today in constructing machine learning models. To this day, Menace is used in machine learning classes to demonstrate a simple functional learning machine that can beat anyone in a game of tic-tac-toe. In fact, you can play an online game with Menace right now. The link is given in the description. But it is truly remarkable how seemingly simple games can drive scientific progress to new horizons. And if you are curious to explore these new horizons yourself, all you need is some beads and, well, some matchboxes. Just be careful not to set anything on fire. If you enjoyed and learned something new, please subscribe, hit the like button, and share it with your friends. It helps a lot in continuing to make more videos like this.